स्टिग्मा इज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ अनअवेयरनेस.
आपको पागलखाने में भर्ती होना है ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. दैट होल कॉन्सेप्ट नीड्स टू यू नो डिफ्यूज.
देयर सो मच अ स्टिग्मा इन आवर सोसाइटी दैट पीपल डोंट इवन वांट टू एक्नॉलेज दैट दे आर लाइक यू नो रियली struggling with a self-esteem issue and things like that.
But it takes a lot of courage to actually come forward, to acknowledge it and to face it.
This whole space, people have come together to talk and discuss mental health. I think that's really important. I think it's really incredible. And most importantly, I think it's very empowering.
Take care of your mental health like you would of your body. So go to a therapist, because going to a therapist is like a gym for your brain. I think everybody should go to a therapist, whether you have a problem or whether you don't. Going to therapy really opens you up.
First, try and get help from a counselor or a therapist rather than go to a psychiatrist, because everyone needs someone to listen to them. And I am a counselor, and I'm here to listen to whoever has the need to be listened to.
Because usually friends will say, "Yeah, let's go have a drink. Well, let's forget about it," etc., etc. But reach out to a professional who can really advise you in the right way, or reach out to me. I will help you meet a professional.
Need to tell the make the parents more aware that if children need help, just be out there for them. It's just like I was telling her that when you're going to hold your child's hand to make him help him write ABCD, it's the same way. If your child is having issues, any kind of issues, just be there for them, hold their hand right through it, and they'll do wonders.
The more you talk to your child, the more you talk among the family, I think we can actually crack the cocoon.
I think we've all shared some very invaluable thoughts and ideas as to where we currently stand and how we may progress from here onward to better times, where we all understand one another better and we bring about naturally a more integrative society.
We are human beings, and we work with the inanimate. It's extremely important that we, within corporate environments, recognize this and take care of the softer aspects of life, living, stress, and not treat it in a compartmentalized manner.
As people, we're not built to extend beyond tribes of 150, and even a mid-sized company now has 4,000, 5,000 employees. So it's not organizationally possible to control mental health through corporate culture. It needs communities and people to be better educated to identify and address issues.
Media is everything, and we have a responsibility right now to humanize the dehumanizing that's been happening using social media, using you know, all these little gadgets that we have, your mic, his camera, you know, mobile phones, and whichever way we can spread that awareness, I think it's there's a lot of pressure in our societies, on our young kids, on our youth today.
Don't take life too seriously. Have a sense of humor and don't get too stressed, you know. We're only here for like 60, 70 years. Have fun, enjoy and chill, man. Don't get too stressed.
Be self-aware. If you really see that, you know, that there are symptoms or things that are not really going in your favor, seek help yourself, because we all are so knowledgeable. We can easily access information of people around us on Google. And second is, become more emotionally intelligent. So the thing is that it's our emotions that are dragging us down, right? So we have to look out for help. Go and look out for people who can help you. Talk to your friends. Don't have stigma around issues. And we as life coaches are more than happy to come and help you out, to come out of all those old patterns which aren't helping for you.
I think the Kadabams and Indus has done an excellent job in striking the gong today, in bringing mental health out of the closet. That is the first task to be performed, and that itself is evangelism.
I think it's so important, the awareness the mental health conclave is creating, and it's something I'm really passionate about, and I'm sure many people here are also very passionate about it. And it's great to see India picking up in mental health.
I think everybody is mentally ill at some point of time, and everyone needs to speak about it.
We all have to sort of look inside ourselves eventually and figure out nice, good ways using social media, embracing it.
And social media can play a vital role in creating awareness. I would encourage anyone and everyone on social media to talk about mental wellness and crush the stigma which is attached or associated with it.
I think more people and more organizations like this that support people, that's what we need. That's what we need for a healthier, happier world.